Welcome to 180 YouTube channel. In this video, we will discuss about the computer basics. Myself Srinivas Darpilli, and this video related to all ITI branches and the syllabus in employability skills. So we know that the computers and internet have made communication faster and reduce the physical distance. They have the improved human capabilities to do the many tasks. There are many advantages in using the computers and today internet. Computers help the quickly find the information, learn new things and communicate with the peoples around the world and manage the life better. Computer helps us learn anything, anywhere, and about anything. So, present situations, all jobs, directly or indirectly, depends upon that internet things. So, internet things through computers. So the computer is nothing but a electronic device or a machine that performs the processing data and calculations and operations based on the instructions provided by the software or hardware program. They are designed to execute the applications and provide the design, the executions, applications, and provide the variety of solutions by the combination of integrated hardware and software components. So basically, we have that some history of the computer. The computer, we know that it today had its beginning with the 19th century English mathematical professor named Charles Babbage. He designed an analytical engine, and it was thin design. It was this design, that computer basics framework of computers, of the today we based on it. So those time, at the time of Charles Babbage, it was called Antonius Berry computer also. So we can called the Charles Babbage is a father of computer also. So in computer development, we have that several generations. First generation, second generation, third generation, like that. In first generation, we was used vacuum tubes. After that, transistors. After that, integrated circuits. And after that, silicon computer chips. So these are that developments. The generation to generation. So basically today we have that computer parts consist of the two mainly nothing but software and hardware parts. So in that we mainly discussed about the four major parts, that's our input and output, CPU and memory. So input devices consisting anything you have will add to the computer. We have to use the microphone and keyboard and mouse and scanners. So those are used for that as input devices, and output devices use that result or what is that calculation we have to find that. Those are displayed on screens and we have to audible in speakers. So you can see that easily on slide also. So we have to give the input by arrow mark in red, while give the some data by using scanner, keyboard or mouse and peripherals like that. So after processing we will get the result. So those are displayed with so those are mentioned with green arrows. So monitor and printer and speakers, so those are give that outputs. So I want to tell about the one of the input device, the keyboard, so which consists of several different keys to operate that. So first one, escape key. So we know that every key function. So cancel that command or series commands, we have to use the escape key. Next one, tab key, moves the cursor to the next tab or stop. So after that, keep caps lock, turn the cap lock latch on off. After that, backspace, we have to use the backspace, move the cursor back and erase the characteristics one space at the time. So after that, we have numeric keypad, allows the faster typing of numbers with the use of one hand. So it is useful for type that numbers very fastly. And next one, the shift button is used to combination with the other keys to type the capital letters or upper symbols on the keys, number keys. Next one, special keys are there, those are control and alt. Control and alt, alt means alternate, those are used for the combination with the other keys to perform the specific tasks. So after the space bar, it is used to move the cursor forward and one space at the time, leaving the blank space. After that, we have that ohm row, which consists of alphabets. Keys where the fingers rest on the typing. Next one, enter returns. Enter information or move or moves the cursor to next line for typing. The finally, directional keys, the move cursor left and right up and down and without erasing text. So some functional keys also there, those also used for that setting, set up that softwares of computer. So those are function keys, F1, F2, F3, so like that. And delete key and print screen key. So those are also used for that some particular functions also. So next one, another device, input device, mouse. So which consists of three buttons. So two buttons with one wheel. First one is the left button. Left button used to draw the place items, select items, space bar equal to R, select the alts. And select that one, marker selected, and double click on the item. It will give that selections. Control key to drag the unselected. Grab and drag the items, reshape, polyface subjects, push the C as a construct, window size and shift buttons. So those are the functions of purpose of left mouse key button. So next one, right mouse button, pick the and select the items, show that constructible menu, draw the walls and lines and draw the satire drawing down and bend the lines and staircase records, resize the pointing objects. So after that, central wheel used to zoom in and zoom out that what are the displaying image, and hold down and to plan your screen, move the items to point to point. So which is the, those are the functions of the mouse. So this is the monitor, we display that what are the result, what is the final we have to obtain by video or audio like that. So we have the several types of monitors, CRT, LCD and LED. CRT means cathode ray tube, and LED lighting emit diodes, and LED types, and LCD light crystal display we have to use in this. So next one, CPU. CPU means a central processing unit, which have that several parts, hard disk, heat sink, and DVD drive and CD drive, RAM, processor, main board, power supply, cooling fan, and floppies. So those are all built in some box. So this total units we can call as CPU. Here the processing will be do that, analyze the calculations like that. What is the function of computers? If we look at in the very broad sense, any digital computers carries the outfalling the five functions. So those are the five steps very important to do that work on computers. Take the data as input, store the data, and process the data into convert useful information and generate the output and control the all of the four steps. So these are the very mandatory steps to do work on computers. So the computer memory is measured in and save the data in binary system, binary numeric systems, which process the data in one or zeros. So this one or zero levels of storage is called a bit. So byte consists of 8 bits, kilobyte consists of 1024 bytes, next megabyte consists of 1024 kilobytes, and gigabytes used of consists of 1024 megabytes. So those are very important bits about that exams, online exams and competitive exams also. So we must remember that values. So after hardware, we have to discuss that operating system means some software, which is a special type of program that loads automatically when you start the computer. The operating system allows the you use that advantage features of the modern computer without having to learn the all details. And the link between the hardware and you, the users, make the computer easy to use without having the understand bytes and bits. So finally, we can use a computer in several tasks. So we have, I can mention some applications of computer used in daily life. And we have to calculate the accounts, we have to play the games, and we can apply applications in individual institutions, and we find that results. And online banking, we can create ID bank, ID cards, we have to use in supermarkets. And working with working from home, we have to use that several tasks. So I can mention some practice bits. So those are what is the computer? Computer is nothing but a programmable device. The correct answer is A. Next one, who is the father of computer? Father of computer is nothing but Charles Babbage. So which among the following first generation computer had? In first generation, we have that vacuum tubes and magnetic drums in first generation. After that, magnetic tapes, after that integrated machines, after that integrations circuits we have to use in history of computers. So next one, CPU stands for controlling processing unit. C is the correct answer. So fifth one, which device used to output device below following? What are that? Keyboard and monitor, mouse and CPU. So keyboard input device, monitor we can display that output, and C is the mouse. D is the CPU processing unit. So B is the correct answer. So a dash electronic device that executes the instructions in a program. So computer is the correct answer, option B. Next, match the following data. So here, accept data is nothing but input, and the processing data is nothing processing unit. Produce the output, nothing but output. Store the result, nothing but storage. So we can find that the data is like that. A will be 4, B will be 3, and C will be 4, and D will be 2. So we can answer that like that. So last one, the physical parts of computer is known as hardware. Physical parts of the computer is known as hardware. So virtual parts nothing but virtual things nothing but software. So I hope you can got that some knowledge about the computer. If you have that any doubts and queries, please ask in the comment section. And in next video I will discuss about that what are the steps to involve to do the work by using computer. So thank you for watching, and please subscribe the channel, and please click on bell icon to new updates. Thank you. Thanks lots.